Are you fascinated by the automation and the accurate measuring mechanisms involved in various industries? Were you interested in electrical and magnetic concepts in plus 2 physics? Then, being an instrumentation engineer might be one of your best interests. Now, what is instrumentation? Instrumentation engineering deals with measurement and control of process variables like level, pressure, temperature, humidity that are used in various industrial processes. The nature of work for an instrumentation engineer will be designing, developing, installing, and managing equipments which are used to monitor and control machinery. Now, the most important one, how to become one? Well, here comes the interesting part, that is about eligibility and dedication. Till 10th, you need to be good in concepts related to physics and mathematics. Now, after 10th standard, diploma is a good option. So, diploma in instrumentation is a 3 years long program. And few institutes also offer diploma plus B.Tech degree in instrumentation engineering. Now, after plus 2, you can join a B.Tech instrumentation engineering, which is a 4-year undergraduate course. Few institutes also offer integrated B.Tech plus M.Tech program in instrumentation engineering. If you want to join a good institution, then you need to crack JEE Advanced for IITs and JEE Mains for NITs. And there are a few other state level important examinations, which are as follows. These are few of the best colleges for B.Tech instrumentation. Not only B.Tech, you can plan for a BSc in instrumentation or BSc honors degree in instrumentation. Now, after you complete your BSc or undergraduate B.Tech degree in instrumentation, you need to go for higher studies, that is Masters, M.Tech or MSc is also another option. For MSc, you need to write JAM, Joint Admission Tests. You can get MSc admissions in IITs through this. For M.Tech, you might be knowing you need to get a good rank in GATE and good percentile to join one of the best institutes in India. These are the few top institutes for M.Tech instrumentation. Now, students after completing their M.Tech can go for PhD in this field. And for lecturership, qualifying UGC NET, the main advantage is you'll be able to teach in universities as a teaching associate, as a lecturer. And you can apply for PhD also. And if you're interested in teaching field, you might have heard about the recent news that now it is mandatory from the year 2021 to have a PhD degree in order to become an assistant professor. Now, certifications. You all know you need to build up your career, learn a lot. So you can do few of the online certifications in various areas like VLSI, PLC, Industrial Automation, SCADA, Python and Robotic courses. Now ISA, International Society of Automation, is the most sought after certification. Here is the reference link. Now attending various seminars, workshops and paper presentation competitions by reputed institutes will help you to get acquainted with various cutting edge technologies. Now, what are the careers? The job opportunities after B.Tech, instrumentation engineers can work in both private and public sector. Now, following are the top companies in India which hire instrumentation engineers. If you're looking a government job, following are some of the PSU companies which hire instrumentation engineers. Now, generally the salary for an average B.Tech instrumentation graduate lies in the range between 1.75 lakh to 9.41 lakh per annum. Now, salary also depends on various factors like your profile of the employee, grades attained by the employee, quality of the institute from which the employee had his or her training. When it comes to government jobs, the average salary might be around 10 to 12 lakhs per annum. Here comes the interesting part, lifestyle. Since you work for industries with automated processes such as chemical or manufacturing plants, your work may be based in an office, laboratory or factory depending on the nature of the organization. Now, your work might be related to visiting various clients from different countries, and working on site is a common aspect of the work. Some positions might carry high levels of responsibility and may be stressful, particularly at very senior level where the accountability of any machine, if it is spoiled or if it is damaged, accountability of any machine lies directly with the instrumentation engineer. Next, coming to highlights and challenges. Instrumentation is a multidisciplinary stream and covers subjects from various branches such as chemical, mechanical, electrical, electronics and computers, thus providing diversified range of jobs after graduation. As instruments are almost used in everyday, need for instrumentation engineers will never subdue. one of the most interesting aspects is it has plenty of specializations like biomedical, VLSI, control systems, and many more to opt after your B.Tech. And you have good chance to work in research and development organizations. In India, almost every public sector unit has certain number of seats dedicated for instrumentation engineers. Now, the challenge is, initially, few of the jobs tend to be low paying compared to other branches like CSC, but the pay scale increases as you gain experience. As most of the times the workplace is inside a manufacturing plant, engineers may get exposed to extreme temperatures, chemicals, dust and debris. Now scholarships. Here are the few organizations which give scholarships. We have a small table for this. Now the most interesting one,
entrepreneurial opportunities.
Home automation and Internet of Things, IoT, are two buzzing words in the market worldwide. An instrumentation engineer can use his technical prowess combined with managerial skills and could start the following business. These are few of the entrepreneurial opportunities you can think of. You can tie up with authorized laboratories and perform and supply instrumentation for calibration and certifications. If someone is skilled in taking repair works, they can take up servicing and AMC of instruments, PLC, drives, etc. One can become dealer for instrument manufacturers and automation system manufacturers. One who has prior knowledge of microcontroller or microprocessor can enable it with sensors and cloud, and thus he can start a home automation services and work according to client's requirements. And last one, commissioning is another big business opportunity where one can perform so many jobs like cable laying, panel erection, instrument mounting, loop check, etc. And the future scope, with hugely booming electronics market and further advancements being done in fuzzy logic, nanotechnology, cloud computing and artificial neural networks, believe me, instrumentation will be a very essential area of focus in every industry. Due to the demand of continuous high levels of efficiency, we can see instrumentation and control will be becoming critical and increasingly important in large industries in the coming years to come. With this, we end this session. We have provided few reference links in the description. Thank you.
If you like the video, please hit the like button, comment, and share it with your friends. Also, don't forget to subscribe for all our future videos.